Dear children, welcome to the EBS online class. Hope you all are staying safe and healthy at home. Have you all gone through previous day's topic? What did we study in the previous class? Yes, adaptations for food in animals. We studied that according to the feeding habits, animals are classified into herbivores, carnivores, omnivores and parasites. The teeth and mouth parts of these animals are adapted to the kind of food they eat. What are parasites? Yes, the animals that feed on living animals and plants are called as parasites. Examples: mosquitoes, fleas, lice, etc. So what is their adaptation? They do not have teeth. Instead, they have sucking tubes as mouthparts. Today, let's discuss about the adaptation for hunting and protection in animals. We know that animals hunt and eat other animals. The hunters have adaptations to catch their prey, while the prey animals have adaptations to escape or defend from their enemies. That is, animals are adapted to hunt and also to protect themselves from enemies. Many animals protect themselves by running away from their enemies. For example, deer and zebra can run very fast. Some animals merge with their surroundings. Thus, it becomes difficult to see these animals. This is known as camouflage. For example, stick insect. It looks almost like a twig. So, it becomes difficult to see it. Another example is chameleon. Chameleons have the ability to change color according to their surroundings. Then polar bear. Polar bears have white fur on their body. This matches with the surrounding snow and thus becomes difficult to spot this bear. Another example is zebra and tiger. They have stripes on their body which makes it difficult to see them in the grassland or forest.
What is camouflage? Ability to merge with the surroundings is called camouflage.
Some animals have spines or shells covering their bodies to protect themselves. For example, porcupine and hedgehog have spines on their body. When a hedgehog senses danger, it rolls up into a ball so that the predators cannot attack it. Then turtles and tortoises have hard shells covering their body. Some animals like rhinoceros and buffaloes use their horns to fight their enemies. Then animals like opossum and some snakes pretend to be dead when they are in danger. Another example is globefish. Globefish can blow itself up to twice its normal size so that it looks bigger and scares away their enemy. Then another example is flying fish. Flying fish. Do they really fly? Yes, they really do. If an enemy chases a flying fish, it jumps out of water and glides using its large fins. So all these are examples for adaptation for hunting and protection in animals. Hope you all have understood the topic.
So we have completed this lesson. Now let's do the text exercises. Open your textbook, page number 83. Section A. Choose the correct options. First question. In which of these places are hibernating animals found? Four options are there: in hot places, cold places, on Indian beaches, underwater. What is the answer? Yes, in cold places. Second question. Which of these animals can live both on land and in water? Here, which is the answer? Frog. Third one, which of these animals is arboreal? Answer is squirrel. Fourth question, which of the following is true of omnivores? Omnivores eat both plants and animals. So here the answer is option D. Fifth question, which of these animals does not have camouflage to protect itself? What is camouflage? The ability to merge with the surroundings. So here, the animal that does not have camouflage is globefish. Section B. Give one word for the following. First question. Long winter sleep. Answer is hibernation. Second question. Going to a warm place in winter and returning in summer. What is the answer? Yes, migration. Third question. Merging with the surroundings to hide from the enemy. That is camouflage. Fourth question. Living on land. That is terrestrial. Fifth one. Living in water. It is aquatic. Sixth one. Living both on land and in water. They are called as amphibian. Seventh one. Living on trees. Arboreal. Eighth question. Spending a lot of time in air. They are aerial. Section C. Write T for true or F for false. First question. Some lizards sleep throughout winter. Is it true or false? It is true. Second question. Dolphins breathe through gills. That is false. Dolphins breathe through their lungs. Third question. Some animals can breathe through their skin. That is true. Fourth one. Herbivores have sharp claws. It is false. Fifth question. Hedgehogs have spines to defend themselves from their enemies. It is true. Section D. Label the following diagrams. You can see two pictures there. First one is a bird and second one fish. So let's label it. First A. It is feather. B. Tail. C. Beak. And D. Leg. Then second picture is that of a fish. And how will you label? E. Tail. F is fin. G. Gills. And H is mouth.
So today we have discussed about adaptations for hunting and protection. Hope you all have understood the topic. Read textbook page number 81 and 82. From notebook, study question number 7 from fill in the blanks. Question number 7 from name the following. And question number 6 from answer the following. A YouTube URL is attached along with this. Watch the video. A test paper is also attached. Do the test and submit it. So let's meet in the next class. Thank you.